மார்னிங் மை டியர் ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ், இன்றைய வகுப்பில் பிளஸ் டூ பயோசுவாலஜியில் ஃபோர்த் யூனிட்டு பிரின்சிபல்ஸ் ஆஃப் இன்ஹெரிட்டன்ஸ் அண்ட் வேரியேஷன் என்ற தலைப்பில் முதல் பகுதி ஹியூமன் பிளட் குரூப்பு, ஆர்ஹெச் பிளட் குரூப்பு, ஆர்ஹெச் இன்கம்பேட்டபிலிட்டி, ப்ரிவென்ஷன் ஆஃப் எரித்ரோபிளாஸ்டோசிஸ் ஃபீட்டாலிஸ் என்ற தலைப்புகளை ஒவ்வொன்றாக பார்க்க போகிறோம்.
Principles of inheritance and variation. You know, my dear student, genetics is the branch of biology that deals with heredity and variation. Heredity deals with how characters are transmitted from the parents to the offspring in generation after generation. Then what is variation? Variation is nothing but individual difference. You know, variation is the raw material for evolution, right? Which is very common among the sexually reproducing animals. Gene, which is the unit of inheritance. You know that the cell which contains nucleus, which is the managing director of the cell, is composed of chromosomes, and the chromosomes composed of DNA. And DNA contains gene. Gene is nothing but a portion of DNA. Then what is allele and multiple alleles? The alternative forms of a gene is called alleles. The alleles may be dominant or recessive. For example, tall versus dwarf, capital T and small t. So each gene has an alternative form, that is called an allele. Then what is multiple allele? When three or more alleles of a gene that controls a particular triad occupy the same locus on the homologous chromosome of an organism, they are called multiple alleles. For example, inheritance of ABO blood group is the best example for multiple alleles. Now, the learning objectives. Under this topic, we are going to study about multiple alleles, the genetic basis of ABO blood group in man, then what is null allele, what is Rh positive and Rh negative, and Wiener hypothesis regarding Rh factor, erythroblastosis fetalis, and genetic control of Rh factor, and what is erythroblastosis fetalis or hemolytic disease. Okay, human blood groups. You know very well, human blood group is the best example for multiple allelic character. Blood differs chemically from person to person. When two different incompatible blood types are mixed, what happens? Agglutination of erythrocyte takes place. Agglutination means clumping of RBC. The basis of this chemical difference is due to the presence of antigen on the surface of RBC and epithelial cells. Karl Landsteiner, who discovered two kinds of antigen called antigen A and antigen B. This is the photograph of Karl Landsteiner, who discovered ABO blood group system. He classified the human population into four groups based on the presence or absence of this antigen. Three kinds of blood groups, type A, type B and type O, were recognized. The fourth and the rarest blood group, type AB, was discovered in 1902 by two of the Landsteiner students, Von D. Kassel and Srulli. The next, Bornstein, in the year 1925, discovered the inheritance of ABO blood group system. According to him, the ABO blood group system is a multiple allelic triad. According to him, there are three autosomal alleles located on chromosome 9 are concerned with the determination of blood group in any person. The gene controlling the blood type has been labeled as I. That refers to isoagglutination or antigen. The I gene exists in three allelic forms, IA, IB and IO. The IA specifies antigen A and IB allele determines antigen B. The IO allele specifies no antigen. Individual who possess this antigen in their fluid such as saliva are called secretors. Each allele IA, IB produce a terminal transferase enzyme. IA allele produce N-acetyl galactose transferase that can add N-acetyl galactosamine to the precursors, that is H substance. IB allele produce galactose transferase that can add galactose to the precursor. Whereas the IO allele do not produce transferase enzyme that cannot add N-acetyl galactosamine or galactose to the precursor and therefore called null allele. You know what is null allele? IO allele are called null allele because they do not produce the terminal transferase. So that cannot add N-acetyl galactosamine or galactose to the precursor. That's why IO allele are called null allele. The allele A and B are dominant. Two allele O. Out of these three allele, allele A and B are dominant alleles. They are co-dominant to each other. Even though there are three alleles, each child receives only one allele from each parent, or otherwise you can say like that. Even though there are three alleles, each person can receive only two alleles. Okay, and now we come to that very important part. There are six genotypes determining four blood groups. And you know very well, the blood group are classified based on the presence of absence of antigen on the surface of the RBC, whereas the antibodies which is present in the blood plasma. IA, the blood group is A, which is responsible for the production of antigen A. And the blood group A contains antigen A and antibody B. What do you understand from this? This antigen and antibody cannot coexist. For example, A group person contains an antigen A whereas antibody B. What happens when antigen and antibody being the same? Then there will be an agglutination reaction. When the blood group contains antigen A and antigen antibody A, they will react with each other and cause agglutination or clumping of RBC. Right? That's why this antigen and antibody cannot coexist. Then IA-IO, which is a heterozygous, which also responsible for the blood group A, right? Which produce antigen A and antibody B. IB-IB, which is a homozygous, responsible for blood group B, and which is responsible for the production of antigen B, and that blood group contains antibody A. IBIO, which is a heterozygous and which is also responsible for the production of blood group B and antigen B and antibody A. Whereas IAIB produce the blood group AB, which contains both the antigen A and B, whereas antibody A or B are absent. Blood group IO responsible for blood group O, they do not produce any antigen, but they contains both antibody A and B. So from that we came to understand there are six possible genotype, whereas which is responsible for only four types of blood groups. Then next we come to that a rhesus or Rh factor. The Rh factor or Rh antigen is found on the surface of erythrocytes, like that of ABO blood group. The antigen is found on the surface of the erythrocyte. This Rh factor was discovered in 1940 by Karl Landsteiner and Wiener in the blood of a rhesus monkey, Macaca rhesus, and later in human beings. Usually, this antigen is found only in the order primate, comes under the class Mammalia, which includes that order primate includes ape, man, and monkeys. The term Rh factor refers to the immunogenic D antigen of Rh blood group system. Then an individual having antigen D are Rh positive, and those without antigen D are Rh negative. Then why we should study about this Rh factor, the role of Rh factor in blood transfusion? Rh factor in the blood is inherited as a dominant trait. This is also very important. Naturally occurring anti-D antibodies or Rh antibodies are absent in the plasma of any normal individual. Listen, my dear student, there is even Rh positive person contains Rh antigen, whereas Rh antibody is naturally absent in any individual. However, when Rh negative person exposed to Rh positive blood cells for the first time, anti-D antibodies are formed in the blood. On the other hand, when Rh positive person receives Rh negative blood, no effect is seen. Then next we come to that very important part. The inheritance of Rh blood group system supported by two groups. There are two hypotheses regarding the genetic control of Rh factor. One is the Fischer and Reyes hypothesis. The other one is the Wiener hypothesis. According to Fischer's hypothesis, the Rh blood group system is controlled by three pairs of Rh alleles. One is CC, DD and EE, occurs at it. Three different loci on homologous chromosomal pair 1. You must know, my dear student, ABO blood grouping multiple alleles are found in the chromosomal 9, whereas the Rh alleles are found in the chromosomal pair 1. The possible genotypes will be 1 CRC or DRD or ERE from each chromosome. For example, CDE, right? All genotypes carrying a dominant D allele will produce Rh positive phenotype, whereas a double recessive genotype small d will give rise to Rh negative phenotype. According to Wiener hypothesis, Wiener proposed that existence of 8 alleles. According to him, Rh blood group is the inheritance of Rh blood group is controlled by 8 alleles. They are R1, capital R1, capital R2, capital RO, capital RZ, small r, small R1, small R2, small RY, at a single Rh locus. All genotypes carrying the dominant R allele will produce Rh positive phenotype, whereas the double recessive genotypes small r will give rise to Rh negative phenotype. See, my dear student, this is how the three pairs of alleles in different locus of the homologous chromosome. Then next we come to that why we should study about this Rh factor. This Rh incompatibility that is responsible for erythroblastosis fetalis. Rh incompatibility has a great significance in childbirth when this complex arises. Usually, when a woman is Rh negative, man is Rh positive, the fetus may be Rh positive. Then what is erythroblastosis fetalis? Erythroblastosis fetalis is a hemolytic disease of newborn child characterized by jaundice and anemia. When a woman with Rh negative and men with Rh positive, then the developing fetus may be Rh positive. The Rh positive baby, which is developing in the uterus of Rh negative woman, develops erythroblastosis fetalis. Normally, the problem arises only at the time of childbirth. See, at the time of childbirth, the child starts to move. When the child starts to move, what happens? There may be a chance for damage of blood vessels. At that time, the child's blood enters into the mother's blood circulation. Then the mother's blood circulation produces Rh antibody against Rh fetal cells. These Rh antibodies, which is produced in the maternal blood, enters into the fetal circulation, where it causes clumping of RBC, and as a result, more and more RBCs are destroyed in the liver. The liver gets damaged, that leads to the jaundice and anemia, which is the characteristic features of erythroblastosis fetalis, and finally the child may die. Because the anti-D antibodies are IgG type, which are very small, that can cross the placenta and enter the fetal circulation. Incompatibility of Rh factor erythroblastosis fetalis. By the time the mother gets sensitized and produces anti-D antibodies, the child is delivered. Usually no effects are associated with the exposure of mother to Rh positive antigen during the first childbirth. Whereas, if the subsequent Rh positive children carried by the same mother may be exposed to antibodies produced by the mother against Rh antigen, which are carried across the placenta into the fetal blood circulation. And this causes hemolysis of fetal RBC, resulting in the hemolytic jaundice and anemia. This condition is known as erythroblastosis fetalis or hemolytic disease of newborn. Then the next, how to prevent the erythroblastosis fetalis? If the mother is Rh negative, the fetus is Rh positive. Anti-D antibodies should be administered to the mother at 28th and 34th week of gestation as a prophylactic measures. If the Rh negative mother delivers Rh positive child, then anti-D antibody should be administered to the mother soon after delivery. This develops passive immunity and prevents the formation of anti-D antibodies in the mother's blood by destroying the Rh fetal RBC. Before the mother's immune system is sensitized, this has to be done whenever the woman attains pregnancy. Now, okay, my dear student. Now we come to that self-evaluation. Choose the best answer. The dash is called null alleles. Answer, IOIO are called null alleles because they do not produce the enzyme transferase. Okay, so IOIO is the null alleles. Then Rh antibodies are dash type. You know very well, Rh antibodies are Ig, immunoglobulin G type. They are very small, that can able to pass through the placenta. Then the third question, inheritance of blood group was studied by Bernstein in the year 1925. Answer C. Which one of the following marriage causes Rh incompatibility? When the marriage is made between Rh positive, male is Rh positive and woman is Rh negative. Option B is the answer. Which of the following phenotype is not possible in the progeny of parental genotype combination? Here answer is D, because both the cases dominant allele is there. So they do not allow to express the recessive allele. So the blood group O is the answer. What are multiple alleles? You know, my dear student, when three or more alleles of a gene that control a particular trait occupies the same locus of the homologous chromosome are called multiple alleles. What is Rh positive and Rh negative? The person with Rh antigen are called Rh positive. Those without Rh antigen are called Rh negative. I write about Wiener hypothesis regarding Rh factor. According to Wiener, Rh blood group system, the inheritance of Rh blood group system is controlled by 8 alleles. Right? Four dominant R allele and four recessive dominant alleles. Those person with dominant R allele will produce Rh positive, and double recessive R allele will produce the Rh negative person or phenotype. How can erythroblastosis fetalis can be prevented? By giving Rh antibodies to the 28th and 34th week of gestation of the mother as a prophylactic doses. And once again, when the Rh negative mother delivered Rh positive child, she has to immunization with the Rh antibody that prevents that develops a passive immunity against Rh. Passive immunity that prevents Rh antibodies by destroying fetal Rh cells. Explain the genetic basis of ABO blood group in man. Five mass question. You know, my dear student, according to Bernstein, ABO blood group is a multiple allelic trait which is controlled by three alleles of a gene. These alleles are the gene of blood group gene is designed as I, and there are three alleles IA, IB and IO. Even though there are three alleles, each person contains only two alleles. Of these three alleles, IA and IB are dominant to IO, right? And there are six alleles, six genotypes, which produce four phenotypes, four types of blood group. Allele IA, IA homozygous produce blood group A. IA, IO blood group A. IB, IB blood group B. IB, IO blood group B. IO, IO blood group O. Right? There are six genotypes but only four phenotypes. Right? And you know very well this allele A and B are codominant. They are equally expressed by producing the antigen A and B. They are codominant. Each allele produce an enzyme transferase, which is very essential. That can add amino acyl. Allele A produce an enzyme transferase, which add N-acetyl galactosamine to the precursor. Allele B produce terminal transferase, which add galactose to the precursor. Whereas the allele O do not produce any enzyme transferase. They are called null alleles. Okay, then what is erythroblastosis fetalis or hemolytic disease of newborn? You know, my dear student, erythroblastosis is a kind of hemolytic disease of newborn, right? Characterized by jaundice and anemia. This is the case only happens when there is a marriage between Rh positive male and Rh negative female. When Rh positive man marries an Rh negative man, the developing baby will be Rh positive. So when this Rh positive baby develops inside the uterus of Rh negative woman, develops the erythroblastosis fetalis. See, the, in this case, the first child will be normal, whereas in the second case, what happens, at the time of childbirth, there may be some leakage of blood vessels, and this blood of child enters into the maternal circulation, where it stimulates the production of Rh antibodies. These Rh antibodies formed in the maternal circulation enters into the fetal circulation, where it causes a clumping of RBC, and that destroys the baby, right? And that's a
இது வரைக்கும் நம்ம பார்த்த தலைப்புகளில் மல்டிபிள் அலீல்ஸ்னால் என்ன, ஜெனட்டிக் பேசிஸ் ஆஃப் ஹியூமன் பிளட் குரூப் சிஸ்டம், ஆர்ஹெச் ஃபேக்டரில் ஆர்ஹெச் பாசிட்டிவ்னா என்ன, ஆர்ஹெச் நெகட்டிவ்னா என்ன, ஆர்ஹெச் இன்கம்பேட்டபிலிட்டினா என்ன, எரித்ரோபிளாஸ்டோசிஸ் ஃபீட்டாலிஸ் எப்படி உருவாகுது, அதை எப்படி தவிர்க்கலாம், இந்த தலைப்புகளில் அமைந்த கேள்விகளை நீங்கள் நல்லா தயார் செய்யுங்க.